Hello, I'm going to talk to you today about using documents as research data and some of the pros and cons of doing this. Using documents as data was becoming more popular even before we went into the COVID-19 pandemic, and now it's even more popular still because it's one of the methods we can still use even if we can't get hold of participants face to face. There are some difficulties though, not least that there's no agreed definition of what a document actually is. If you think of all the kinds of documents you can think of, it might include things like books and wills and leaflets. They're very varied, very variable, and it can be hard to pin down exactly what a document is. But people generally do agree that it's a container of words and images that transmits information, and that's a working definition we can go with for the time being. On the basis of that definition, there are lots and lots and lots of documents. Many, of course, are only available in hard copy, perhaps in archives, in organisations or in national archives or in libraries. But an increasing number are available online, which is helpful because they're often easier to get hold of unless they're paywalled or in some other kind of online confidential space. But online documents are often quicker and easier to find than hard copies. However, another downside is that documents may be incomplete, whether they're in hard copy or online, or they may be misfiled. They may exist, but they may be impossible to find because somebody just put them in the wrong place or ticked the wrong box. And the quality is variable. Just because something is a document doesn't mean it's necessarily good or useful or has true, accurate, factual information to give you. Also, even if you have good quality documents, like say meeting minutes from different committees, meeting minutes are quite official documents and they're usually carefully taken, but it can be difficult to compare meetings minutes from different committees because they may be dealt with differently. Some committees will just record actions, whereas others will record key points of discussion, whereas others again may record pretty much everything that's been said. So trying to compare those different groups of meeting minutes can be really complicated. So documents can be hard to manage, but on the plus side, particularly if you're working with available online documents, this is very cost effective. You can collect your data from your desk, from your device, and that saves time because documents that are freely available electronically can be found by searching electronically, either using generic search engines or more dedicated ones, perhaps within National Archive websites. Also, there's an ethical plus to using documents in that they place no burden on participants and they reduce the so-called researcher effect. You're not affecting the content of the documents have already been created. You're just searching for them to use in your own research. They're useful in a whole bunch of disciplines, particularly perhaps disciplines like history, policy, media, these kind of studies where documents are a key part of the field, but also useful in just about any discipline really, if only for providing context for other research work. So documents used as data don't have to be the only data that you use, they can be just part of the data, perhaps in a multimodal study. But they can add context, they can add depth, they can add a different perspective to other forms of data. And depending on your research topic and question, you may be able to answer your research question using documents alone. I wouldn't suggest trying to create a question specifically so that you can answer it using documents, unless you're really doing just a sort of small research project for study purposes, then you could perhaps justify that. But in terms of real world research, it's more about thinking, is there scope for documents to help you answer your research question? And if so, how could they do that? I can suggest a couple of books to you that may help. There's one by Amy Grant, which is very useful, very practical, has exercises for you to do and lots of different types of analytic work explained in good detail. And then another one by Malcolm Tight, which also talks about different types of documents, how to collect them and how to analyse them. I've written a little about document analysis in my own creative methods book, but if you want to do it seriously, I would recommend those books. If you can only afford one, probably Amy Grant's, but if you can get hold of both, and again, you may be able to get e-versions from a library, then there'll be really useful texts to help you with using documents as research data. Thank you.